Hey guys, welcome to Alex Every Day, and today I'm going to teach you how to make this picture frame hanger decoration that spells out love. Now, it is a very simple project. It's very straightforward, a lot of cuts, some nails, glues, and screws, but it's very simple, very easy. It does take time to adjust everything the right way, and it is just lovely, and I decided to make it for my wife, so it makes great gift ideas. It's just a joy to do. So without further ado, let's get to the build. So guys, first thing that we gotta do is measure out our boards. This project is very straightforward. It's just measure, cut, and start putting together. Now for the complete cut list, it is down in the description down below. There you'll find absolutely everything that you need to measure out and cut the right way. Now if you do have a miter saw, it's a lot quicker and it's just better because you're gonna be able to put a stop block and have your cuts exactly the same in each block. And it's not necessary, but it's just gonna make it faster if you do have one. If you don't, you just do it with a circular saw as I did, and it just takes a little bit more time. Now after we got all of our pieces, we do want to sand down every edge. Just make sure that there's no splinters. For me, my circular saw did give me a lot of splinters on these pieces, so I just took a little bit of time and just sand down every edge, make sure it's all square, and there's nothing that's going to cut me later. Now for the assembly. Now this is gonna take a little bit of time, and I do recommend to use, as you will see, I will be using brand nails. This is just to hold things in place until I figure out exactly how I want it, and then I will be using screws for the main support. Now I'm gonna build this in three sections. I'm gonna build the first part is gonna be the top part, which is gonna be the L and the O. Then I'm gonna move down to the E at the end, and then we're gonna work on the V. Now the V is cut with 30 degree angles, which you're gonna see later. But the first part is just putting the L and the O together. And then later, I'm gonna screw the V. The V is gonna be the main part to get everything together with some screws. So I'm gonna screw down the V onto the middle of the O and onto the E at the bottom, with just one frame. Now to do this, you could either start from the middle, which I would recommend, or you could start how I did. And then take apart the bottom part of the E and then put your screws through so your screws will be hidden, and then you assemble the E at the end. Or you can just start with a V and actually drill down both the top and the bottom of the V and then continue from there. Now that process is going to be a little bit more confusing since you're not building in order. So that's why I chose to start with the L, then the O. Now for the top part of the L, it's just gonna be a 9-inch. And then for the base of the L, which is gonna make the top of the O, is gonna be the 18-inch. Each side of the O is also gonna be 9 inches, making it a complete square. Now I am applying glue to this, which is the reason that's gonna make it a lot sturdier later. But I am also counting that it's not gonna dry up right now, and that's why I just use the brand nails to keep everything in place. Now, I do recommend to do the outside of the O and then the inside, so that way you don't make this mistake that I did not fit it right perfectly and it wasn't a perfect square. So I had to remove one of the pieces and then do it again. Now this project, I am doing it as I go, so that's why you're gonna see me go back and forth and fix a couple things. With the L and the O ready, we're going to do the E, which is very simple. Just use your 9-inch at the side, 9-inch at the top, and 9-inch at the bottom, and then a 6-inch in the middle. Again, I do repeat that you will be taking off the top part, so no need to put 3 brad nails on it. Just put 1, you're good to go, because you're going to remove it to add the screws for the V, which is going to be what holds everything together. And the bottom, you will add some screws as well, so it holds everything perfectly straight. Now the center for the E is going to be fine with just some glue and some brad nails. You will not have to drill some screws into that part. Once the glue dries up, it'll be sturdy enough. With the top part and the bottom done, let's get to working on the middle. Now with your 12 3/4 inch pieces, now we need to cut them with the correct angle, which can be 30 degrees. Here I'm just making a rough reference so I can see what angle for each side we need to cut. Now remember, you need to cut on the bottom and you need to cut on the top so it actually lays flat, holding up the rest of the top part. You can do this carefully on your table saw or with a circular saw as well. Just put it to 30 degrees and cut through. Once you have your pieces cut, make sure you do sand it just a little to remove any splinters. Now you can go either way to assemble this. You can do it either flat or you can put it at the top. Now I'm just doing a dry run to see how it is, and later I'm gonna drill the holes. Always remember to drill your pilot hole first, then countersink, and then put your screws through. Thank you. As I mentioned before, I'm removing the top of the E just so I can take care of all this part, and then I'll be screwing it down later. Now the O, I did not have to take it apart since I had enough space for my drill. If you don't, go ahead and remove the bottom part, drill in your screws, and then you can assemble everything together so it's nice and sturdy. Oh. with the frame ready and everything is nicely supported, all you have missing is the last piece of the V. And you can set this either laying on the table, and I just found it's easier if you actually stand everything up and just glue it to the side, and it just stays right there. Put some brad nails through it just to hold it, and you're done. So there you go, guys. I hope you enjoyed this build. It was quite easy. I know I'm gonna give it a little bit of finish and I'm just gonna put it on the wall. You can put some nice picture frames in here. It's quite sturdy, so it's gonna be able to hold some load on it. Not too much, but picture frames are fine. I really enjoy doing this. If you know somebody that might enjoy doing this type of project or yourself, just make sure you share it with family members. Or make sure you do a great gift. Now, if you enjoyed this build, please give it a thumbs up and let me know in the comments below what you thought of this or how did yours go. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on your notification bell so you know when the next build comes out. Thank you again, and I'll see you on the next build.